won't start the program. Somebody else is going to start the program. Thank you.
Proclamation, starting January 1st, 1863, Freedom goes to all enslaved people.
In 1863, the Battle of Galveston.
On January 1st, 1863, the same day the Methodist Proclamation took effect, the Battle of Galveston began. The Confederate forces under Major General John B. Magruder captured the city of Galveston from occupying Union troops.
In 1863, the United States establishes the U.S. Colored Troops.
Early in 1863, the U.S. War Department issued General Order Number 143, which sanctioned the creation of
1864 to 65, the 13th Amendment.
On April 8, 1864, the U.S. Senate passed the 13th Amendment and abolished and ended slavery in the U.S., except as a form of punishment. On January 1, 1865, the U.S. House of Representatives passed the 13th Amendment. In December of 1865, 27 of 26 states ratified the 13th Amendment and it became the law. 3/4 of the state was required, and slavery was then illegal.
In 1865, the Civil War ends.
On April 9th, General Lee surrenders the Army of Northern Virginia. On May 26th, General Smith surrenders the Army of the Trans-Mississippi, which includes the Texas Army.
1865. Colored troops defend the 13th Amendment.
By May 1865, nearly 16,000 U.S. colored troop veterans of the 25th Corps arrived at Brazos, Santiago, from City Point, Virginia. Troops served in Fort Brown at Brownsville, Ringo Barracks at Rio Grande City, Fort McIntosh at Laredo, Fort Duncan at Eagle Pass, and smaller posts where they were assigned to prepare for former Confederates from establishing the defeated government.
One of those regiments was here on Galveston Island on Juneteenth. June the 19th.
Hey!
Hey!
The taller I get.
Well, that is the program. We are thankful to U.S. Major General Guard Ranger, led by the Right Reverend Dr. Stephen Duncan of Galveston, for welcoming all of us to this historic site on this historic day, along with the Freedom School staff members under the direction of Sue Johnson, giving us the historical significance of this day. My name is Douglas Matthews, and I will be serving as your master of ceremony. Today, we celebrate the 154th anniversary of Juneteenth, and the 40th annual Cal Emperor's Juneteenth prayer breakfast at this historic location, the 1857 Ashton Villa Mansion. This mansion once served as the residence of the Confederate Army officers before U.S. Major General Gordon Granger arrived here with 2,000 troops. We will now have our opening prayer by my good friend, Reverend Lewis Simpson, Jr., pastor of St. John Baptist Church, followed by the singing of Lift Every Voice and Sing, the Negro National Anthem. For those of you who do not know the words to the song, we have included the insert at each table, so please feel free to join in. Is that okay, Mr. Thomas?
Let us bow our heads. Eternal God, our Father, we come this morning, first of all, just to say thank you. For Father, you've allowed us to see another day. Then you've allowed us to celebrate another 40th annual Al Edwards Juneteenth. Father, we come thanking you, realizing that you're so gracious and you're so kind. And oh Lord, just as you led the children of Israel out of Egypt, you led us out of captivity. And for that, Father, all of us ought to just say thank you. Lord, we thank you for this day, asking that you would go with us, allow your spirit to fall afresh on each one of us. Use us in a special way, and always allow us to recognize and realize the significance that you placed in each one of us through your spirit. Now, Lord, thank you for what you have done. We thank you for what you shall do. But most of all, we want to say thank you for what you're doing right now. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Let us just all say amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
path through the blood of the slain.
Galveston on June 19, 2006, to honor the leadership of Al Edwards. And whereas former State Representative Al Edwards of Houston will be celebrating his 40th annual celebration at the historic Galveston Ashtonville Mansion on June 19, 2019. Therefore, we, the Mayor and City Council of the City of Galveston, do hereby proclaim June 19 as Honorable Al Edwards Day, the former State Texas Representative of Houston, Texas. This is the City of Galveston, and we urge all citizens to celebrate our diverse culture and heritage and continue our efforts to create a world that is more just, peaceful, and prosperous for all. And it is signed by our Mayor, Jay Jarborough, and our State Secretary, Janelle Williams.
Next, we will have greetings from Galveston County Commissioner Stephen Holmes, who has served in the capacity for 20 years, a Dickinson High School football standout, a Rice University football player and graduate, a TSU Thurgood Marshall Law graduate, and former assistant district attorney, my hero.
Good morning, everybody. Happy Juneteenth. All right. Let me first of all say to the Baptist to thank you out there, Al Edwards, for all he did for making Juneteenth a state holiday in the state of Texas. And he, every year that he's able, he's been here for the last 40 years. And I want to thank Doug Matthews as well. Doug, give Doug a round of applause. All right. Not only for this program, but for other programs that he puts on throughout the month of June. So he really does a great job of making sure. And making sure that we as a community don't forget the significance of Juneteenth. Not only statewide, but countrywide, but the significance that it holds for us here in the city of Galveston. I think Doug does a good job doing that for us here in the city of Galveston. But you know, it's a special day. Gordon Granger and his students arrived 154 years ago. Today, if you think about it, it's an amazing, amazing feat that we are here in Galveston, the place where all of that began. And I think I'm grateful to be here. I'm grateful for all the things, grateful for all the things that have happened. And you know, when you think about history, you think about all those people who were responsible for Juneteenth to happen, for that to happen at that time. The progress that has been made over the last 154 years, not only for African Americans, but for our country as a whole. But it's a good time for us to not only to reflect, but to look towards the future. The work that we still need to do as a race, as a people, and as a country to make lives better, not only for African Americans, but for everybody here. So happy Juneteenth, everybody.
Thank you. Next, we will have greetings from the state of Texas, Michael Jenkins. If he's here, legislative aide. He's not here, okay? But state representative Mays Bill. Okay, he's not here, so next we'll have a musical selection from a dynamic young group, the Fanfare Lutheran Music Academy, and the executive director, June Collins Pulliam, will come up and introduce the people. That's what I was calling. Yeah, but.
Together for 6 days, and we, in the tradition of of the spiritual Lord, we're seeing two selections, Wade in the Water and Down in the River to Pray. And our performance is dedicated to Mrs. Isola Collins, who we cannot think about spirituals or Juneteenth without thinking about her.
Thank you.
U.S. Representative Randy Weber is District Director Jeb Webb, who's going to bring greetings. The Congressman couldn't be here today. He has participated before in all our events, and followed by Rose Caballero, Chief Employment Opportunity Officer for the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, and a minister in the church, her and her husband both, and Lamar. And then followed by Colonel Lars Zebrastrong, District Engineer and Commanding Officer for the Galveston District of U.S. Army Corps of Engineers. This will be his third year participating. Okay. I'll let them come up.
Awards of the Lord. And I'm not going to go into all of the introduction. I hope if you're listening to her, you didn't begin to question my intelligence that I couldn't figure out what a Juneteenth was. I know it's the same day every year. But I'm glad that I'm here for my third year. Unfortunately, my final year in this capacity, but maybe depending on my future, we'll be able to continue to participate in a civilian capacity. So, good morning again. I do consider it a privilege and honor to stand before you today and to bring greetings from the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers. Chairman, thank you once again for your invitation to participate. It is truly appreciated. As the Galveston District Commander, I've had the awesome opportunity for the past 3 years to celebrate and commemorate the historic Juneteenth celebration with all of you. I have learned so much from this experience and why we celebrate Juneteenth, because of the freedom of the African-American people. When on June 19, 1865, the Union soldiers led by Major General Gordon Granger landed in Galveston with news that the war ended and that the enslaved people were now free. Even though this was 2.5 years after President Lincoln's Emancipation Proclamation, this still served as the great news for the African Americans of Texas and helped to pave the way to create the rich and diverse culture that comprises the city of Galveston, the state of Texas, and our nation today. Today, the Army continues to serve the United States with extraordinary soldiers and civilians who display exceptional character in defense of our nation. Now, if I could, are there any veterans in the room? Would you please raise your hand? In a few short days, I will become one of you and I will become a veteran. But on behalf of the active duty military and reserve, thank you for your sacrifices and thank you for defending our freedom. I know it is not lost upon you every day you look back on your service, but especially today. The irony that to serve in our military, we all must sacrifice our personal freedoms, but we understand that that sacrifice is for the greater good of our nation and society. So thank you, veterans. So we at the Galveston District of the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers are part of this Army tradition, and we are proud of the service we continue to provide to all of you. Just to share a brief history of the Army Corps of Engineers, we have been in existence since before our nation declared its independence. The Corps of Engineers has been here in Texas since it became a state, and specifically the Galveston District has been serving the people of Texas and our nation continuously for the past 139 years. We were founded in 1880, only 15 years after Juneteenth. Our first mission was navigation, and our second mission was protection from coastal storm. Those of you who enjoy the beach here in Galveston know the historic seawall that we constructed more than 100 years ago. And that's our historic legacy, but today we continue to focus on navigation and coastal storm risk management, but also flood risk management, ecosystem restoration, regulation of development of our environment, and emergency management are all key missions of the Army Corps of Engineers today. Unfortunately, on July 2nd, I will relinquish command of the Galveston District to Colonel Timothy R. Bale, a native of Spring, Texas, who is proud to return home. During my transition, I plan on briefing him on my participation in Juneteenth and encourage him to continue the trend that I've begun and to present to all of you in the future. So as I transition from military to civilian life, I will pause to recognize the vital legacy Juneteenth and celebrate African American freedom and achievement while encouraging continuous self-development and respect for all cultures. Because as Mr. Webb stated, the strength of our nation is our military, and the strength of our military is our diversity. So all of us constitute this great nation, and it takes everyone from all of our perspectives and all of our backgrounds to continue to further our nation and our goals and our ideals until we become that perfect union. So I would like to express my farewell and to express my thanks and honor to serve all of you here in Galveston for the past 3 years, but also for my 25 years of service. S.A.L.S.
Thank you, Colonel. Next, let us all stand and sing God Bless America.
Councilwoman Amy Block. I see my
not asked if I had, do we have any other elected officials in the House that are members? Okay, I think that's it.
I forgot to recognize my sister, LaJerry Matthews. My young sister, 7 years younger. The baby. Small baby. Got everything. I was a milk child. My wife said, stay the script. Okay, next we'll have a very special presentation. I would like to first recognize our corporate sponsors, UTMB, SLS, and that's the Sullivan Land Service, Cynthia and George Mitchell Foundation, and Old Central Culture Center. And this is our third 2019 Juneteenth event this year, and we would like to make a special presentation to the Cynthia and George Mitchell Foundation. They have been one of our most loyal and dependable sponsors, supporters for the past 7 years. More specifically, of the 18 years that I've worked at the City of Galveston as City Manager and Assistant City Manager, Mr. George Mitchell, the father, was a wonderful person to work with. He was responsible for the revitalization of Galveston's historic downtown area, the construction of the Galveston Cruise Ship Terminal, the development of the Pier 21, the resurrection of the Galveston Mardi Gras celebration, a major West End housing developer, Pirates Beach. He did the first beach sand restoration project in Galveston, the construction of the San Luis and the Tremont House Hotel, and when I was fired from the City of Galveston 24 years ago, he hired me. He said, Doug, you're now going to work for me until you get a permanent job, because I don't want you to sit at home and feel sorry for yourself. And so, I mean, I just owe this gentleman and this family so much. And accepting the award today is from the Mitchell Family Foundation is the son, Grant Mitchell. Please come up. And the award says the Galveston Juneteenth Committee proudly presents 2019 Lifetime Achievement Award to the Cynthia and George Mitchell Foundation in honor of your financial support to the Galveston Annual Juneteenth Celebration, June 19, 2019.
That's quite an honor, quite an honor. Let me give me one moment while I open my crutch. So, 2 years ago, two more than that, I did a few produced, directed, wrote a few films here, and one was The Great Swarm, which still plays, Pirate Island, Jean Lafitte, and a film on the other side. And in that time, I read a lot about Galveston history, went deep into Galveston history, reading a lot. Now I serve as president of Mitchell Historic Properties, which manages about 20 historic buildings in downtown Galveston, the Hotel Galvez, and Tremont House, all of which were restored by my parents over the last 40 or so years of their lives. My family and I, and the great team we work with here in Galveston, consider ourselves stewards of a piece of Galveston's history and legacy. And in that role, I have long said that Juneteenth is the most important day in Galveston history. And for good reason. Today is a day for jubilation. We celebrate this day as the day word reached Galveston and then spread throughout the region and into other southern states that freedom had come to millions and a great injustice had been undone. We celebrate the day we got word our great nation, torn apart but once again united, had taken one bold and decisive step toward fulfilling promise at the core of a Poets' Creed, that all people are created equal. But this is not just a celebration. The path toward justice is long and uncertain. It sometimes moves forward and sometimes winds its way back. So today is also a day of reflection. It's a day to look around and ask ourselves, where are we on that path? Are we fulfilling the promise of our founders' words? Are we reaching our potential of a society that is inclusive, equitable, and just? Is opportunity equally distributed? It is a day to consider, are we doing everything we can do as individuals in our daily lives and as a society to keep moving forward along that righteous path? Dr. King said, injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. And in his words, so true, we can understand why Juneteenth is such a powerful and meaningful day, not just for those whose ancestors took back their freedom, but for all Galvestonians, all Texans, all Americans. So as we celebrate and reflect, we do so in a city with its own interesting story. This port city, a gateway to the world, is a city built by immigrants for immigrants. Though by no means perfect, this is a city that thrived in its best days, not in spite of its diversity, but because of its diversity. And we should never forget that. My father, George Mitchell, was born 100 years ago last month on this island to Greek immigrants of meager means. He was raised in neighborhoods not far from here, full of people whose heritage spanned the globe. Growing up around families who practiced different religions, spoke different languages in their homes, and practiced different customs, he naturally developed a love for people from all walks and learned to judge people by the content of their character. He had many traits that led to his success, including a dedication to lifelong learning, determination, and hard work. But that trait, the habit to look beyond one's prejudices, was one not often shared by the professional peers of his day, and that gave him a perspective and an advantage that was one key to his success. It was a gift given to him by the city. I'm happy to hear Mr. Matthews here confirm what I'm saying. It's very gratifying that it's just not my perspective as someone who admired my father, but coming from Mr. Matthews, it means a lot. And not to forget, my mother, Cynthia Woods Mitchell, spent her formative years in Jacksonville, Illinois, before moving to Texas. She moved to Texas shortly after graduating from high school. Now about Jacksonville. During the mid-1800s, Jacksonville had a vibrant abolitionist community and had been a major center of the Underground Railroad during the time of slavery. Jacksonville's pride in its abolitionist history ran deep, and my mother carried her city's heritage with her as a fiery passion for what was just. We joke within the family that the Cynthia Doctrine was an intolerance of intolerance. With her passion, it was fun watching them together as issues of race or identity came up. Yes, my father saw past these things, but he was a human being, and when he stumbled, veered slightly off course, or God forbid, took one step back, she was always right there, quick to remind him of his humanity and the person he wanted to be. She always lit the way if he wavered and kept his compass true. And he loved her for that. We all loved her for that. So we, their children, grandchildren, and great-grandchildren carry their values within us. And so it is in their names that I accept this great honor on behalf of our family and the Cynthia Ward Visual Foundation. Explore the wonder of each other's perspectives. As we work toward greater understanding, let us all recognize the great gift of our diversity and understand that we are all not just better off by bridging our differences, we are better off because of our differences. Thank you.
We honor his awareness, which led him to the understanding and action. We present Mr. Herman Kleinke with the 2019 Juneteenth Reverend James B. Thomas Humanitarian Award. I don't believe he's here, but he's an educator with GIS.
Yeah. pretty case of the resemblance between Al and me. I often get confused for Al. It's a hello, Al. Then I say hi, but that's my brother here. He's 10 years older than me. He is, as Doug said, he is on his way. I really like to say, one, I grew up here at a time that Juneteenth celebration was always in the backyard, even though it was years after we were given our freedom, we were not supposed to celebrate. The major thing here is that we publicly celebrate Juneteenth. I'm proud of my brother to have authored the legislation to make this state a legal holiday. It actually turned out to be.
Yes. Father, as we come to the close of this celebratory event of Juneteenth, Lord, we give you praise and glory.
How you doing?
For what the presenters have presented unto you today. Lord, we pray that it was acceptable in your sight. Now, Lord, we ask that as this day progresses, let us do all that we can this day to enjoy you and this Juneteenth and what's happened on this great day. Father, we thank you for all that have been a part of this presentation. Now, Lord, we pray, not only would you bless your people, but that you would bless the food we're about to have. It's in Jesus' name. Let us all say amen.
Amen.